Hi YouTubers, making a little video today of this tire changer that I bought from Princess Auto. Same thing as Harbor Freight. You can get it at Harbor Freight. That's the US side, and for us Canadians it's Princess Auto. Paid about 50 bucks for it. I just want to do a little video of how easy it is to change these tires with the machine. I see a lot of guys killing themselves with the thing, but it's not that hard once you have a technique. I have it mounted on a skid right now. Well, I always have it mounted on a skid. Just because I didn't want to make holes in the concrete. I don't use it very often, once in a while, but like I said, as long as you don't kill yourself, the skid works good for me. I'm just gonna put the camera down and start with the tire chain. So I guess the first thing we do, take the valve stem out. You need a little tool like this. Hopefully you can see that pretty good. Remove the stem, so we get all the air out. Anytime you break the bead on pretty much any tire, you always want to start with the back first. If you do the front, you'll have a tougher time getting the back off after. That's your bar. And you might have to give it a couple turns. Sometimes you get lucky on one shot, but sometimes you have to give it a few tries. Okay, now we set the tire inside the holder here. Sometimes this can be a little bit of a pain. Just want to show you inside there. Look at that one there, sometimes it's loose. And just line it up so this way when you tighten up it doesn't spin on you. That's all it's there for.
Lock on.
Now, for this stuff here, you really don't have to put the tire lube, but I always like it. This makes it easier. Turns out easier. You could use just soap and water. I like using this stuff. It's rim lube. Rim slip, they call it this one, but same stuff. Just get your bar. You got this end here. This part here always goes onto the rim part. And the top is the rubber. That's one side. The back side, always push it down so it gives it a little bit more room. Put the bar down. You know why I use the skid? You really don't need that much pressure. As long as you have a good technique. Right. Same thing. Well, this is that. Okay, now I'm just gonna pause the video. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean up the tire a little bit, clean up the rib. And I'll be back before I put the sealer on. Okay, I guess we're back now. Now it's time to put the, you know, like I said, all this stuff you don't have to do. I originally put these on with no tires, no tire bead sealer, and that's probably why I was getting a little bit of a leak. But it's always a good idea to put this stuff on. It's called tire bead sealer. You can see that. I'm going to apply this on. I'm just going to do around the rim. Never instructions with this stuff. I just YouTubed it and I see a lot of people just putting it on the rim instead of the tires. That's the way I've been doing it. Doing a nice coat all around.
Stuff dries pretty quick too, so. So if you got a bad rim, sometimes you might want to even give it two coats. Okay, one side. Some guys let this bead sealer dry. Some guys are even 24 hours. I'm not really sure proper procedure for it, but I tried many ways and tried the 24 hour. That seems to be work the best because it sticks, kind of dries on there and creates like a coating. But like I said, these are not that bad, these rims, so I don't worry about it too much. Just let it dry for a few minutes. All right, now we get the tire ready. Soap all around. Here's another thing too. Some guys say don't do the outside. I do. I never did. I just used to do the inside, but I always find it. Just works good this way. I haven't had an issue, so that's why I just stick with this routine. Actually, I find it works a little better. Okay, so this thing's ready to put on. Let me lock the rim before I forget. Okay, so don't forget which way you're going, the rotation. Tire's got to go on this way. Okay, this part is probably the easiest part where it just slides on. You don't really need the bar or anything. Slides it like that. And then for this part, you need the bar. So now you take the opposite end of the bar. See, it's got a little oval. This is going to sit on the rim part in here, and the tire will sit on here. On that side, put your hand on the back, moving your way around. And as you're moving your way around, make sure that this side here, the back side, you always push it down because you want the lip to get into the groove. Because if you don't, you won't have enough room for the tire to stretch. Just go around a little bit. That's it. Easy as that. Okay, now we get the air. Because I have no valve stem in here, you can just use a blow gun and pump it up. If you have a tough time with them and you have to jiggle around the tire in order to catch, like for example this one, give me a tough time. Well, that one there caught. But if you have a tough time, I have another chuck that's like this with no valve in it. And I suppose I can use this one. Put that on there. Put the tire pressure to the proper pressure. This takes 6, but I'll probably put it to 10. Just so that everything seals good. Nothing. Okay. And that's pretty much it. Sure, it's seated. Yep. And that's it. We're pretty much done. I don't know, I didn't time it, but I'm sure I'll check the timer and see how long it took me. It's usually pretty quick. But like I said, for my best $50 I've ever spent, Princess Auto, Harbor Freight. You know, it comes with the stand itself, the bar, and the locks. And the breaker bar, I guess that's on there. Like I said, and I just, on a skid, works for me. It would be better if I put it in the concrete, obviously, but yeah, like I said, you just saw me doing it. I really didn't have to drill holes, so. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully, this video helps someone else out there. For $50, like I said, one tire change pays for it. Take care.